A warm welcome to you from SDT University. I'm Dr. Jasmine Nindra, Faculty of Dental Sciences. Today, I will be demonstrating you on how to fabricate a labial bow. Labial bow is the active component of an orthodontic removal appliance which applies forces to the teeth to bring about the desired tooth movement.
The basic design of a labial bow comprises of a horizontal bow, two vertical loops and two retentive arms. Now, what are the uses of a labial bow? It can be used as a component of Holly's retainer for retention of teeth after active orthodontic treatment, second, for slight reduction of anterior teeth, and lastly, for attachment of auxiliary springs and soldered attachments. Now, there are certain modifications done in the design of the labial bow to form the various varieties of the labial bows, such as the short labial bow, long labial bow, a split labial bow, then the Roberts retractor, a reverse loop labial bow, the Mills retractor, then a high labial bow with apron springs, then a fitted labial bow, and soldered labial bow.
So now, I'll start demonstrating the steps in fabrication of the labial bow.
Armamentarium required for fabricating a labial bow. We require a stainless steel Leon 0.7 mm gauge wire, an orthodontic model, universal plier, Adam's plier, Moon's cutter, pencil and a marker. So first, I begin with marking the middle third of the anterior teeth from canine to canine. Then we mark a point between the mesial third and the middle third of the crown. And at this point, U-loop of the labial bow will be formed. Then, crossing over the occlusal area, and this is the retentive arm and finally the retentive tag. Now we take a length of stainless steel wire and using the finger and thumb pressure, the wire is contoured into an ideal arch. With continuous finger pressure, a uniform arch is formed without any sharp bends. And now I straighten the distal ends of the wire. Make sure while doing this, the plane of the wire is not distorted. And then check the arch form over the cast such that it touches all the teeth. And now I mark the center of the central incisors over the wire. Make sure the wire is touching all the anterior teeth. Now make a mark on the wire to form the U loop. Now using the universal plier, we bend the wire at this point 90 degrees down. This bend is at 90 degrees to the arch form made in the anterior region. Now we mark 2 to 3 mm gingival where the U loop will be placed. Now using the universal plier, U loop is formed around the rounded beak of the universal plier. Both the legs of the U-loop should be parallel to each other. And now we check it over the orthodontic model. Now contour the distal leg of the U-loop towards the model. Now mark the contact points and the occlusal area so that you bend the wire crossing over the occlusal area for making the retentive arm. After completing one side of the labial bow, you can check it over the cast. Now starting with the other side of the labial bow, again we mark a point between the mesial and the middle third of the canine. Now on the other side, we again give a 90 degrees bend down to make the U loop. Now mark a point 2 to 3 mm gingival to the gingival margin where the U loop will be formed. Again, the U loop is formed around the rounded peak of the universal plier. Make sure the plane around which the U-loop will be formed is in the same line with the arch of the anterior portion of the labial bow. Now check it on the orthodontic cast, and similarly the distal leg of the U-loop is contoured over the orthodontic model. Now marking the contact points, now we start making the retentive arm on the other side of the labial bow. Now contour the retentive arms over the palatal region such that the labial bow is passive over the orthodontic model. Now finally, making the retentive tags. For retentive tags, you make a loop at the end of the retentive arm. Now check for the adaptation of the labial bow over the orthodontic model. So this completes our labial bow. Points to check are: the labial bow touches all the anterior teeth and it lies at the middle third of all the anterior crowns. These are the two retentive arms and the two U-loops which are equal in length.
So today we have learned how to make a labial bow, and the next time we meet we will be discussing the different types of labial bows in detail. Till then, keep learning, keep growing. See you next time.